Hello everyone, welcome to my channel. Today I'm gonna show you guys some serious information on a gear oil. Which one are the best gear oil and which ones are the worst gear oil you can use in your vehicle. Sometimes we think the big brand names are the best, but in reality, you know, big names are not always the best. And as you can see in the chart, there is fail, there is a medium, and there is a lowest number. Well, the one that says fail, it's actually Mobil 1 gear oil. It actually failed. That was the industry requirements. It doesn't meet the standards. It does not even meet the standards that are required for gear oil. Amazing. You know, it's been tested, and this testing was done by an independent testing facility. How do they do the testing? Let me show it to you guys. As you can see right here on the screen, I have three samples. This is what the independent testing, this is how some of the testings are done by independent labs. You know, anyone can send their samples. They don't put the name. You can't tell by this oil what's in the bottle. There's only numbers 4, 2, and 3. Can you guys say which one is which? Which one is the Mobil? Which one is the Castrol? Which one is the M-Soil? You can't tell by that. So this is how some of the tests are done by independent labs. You send them a sample, you label the samples, and you ask them to do the testing. In this case, three samples were sent to the lab, Valvoline, Mobil, and M-Soil. And as you can see on the screen, Mobil 1 failed to meet the requirements of industry standard. The Valvoline is very close up there. It's not really doing a good job. As you can see, the type of testing was done was the Brookfield viscosity testing, meaning how well is the gear oil provides the lubrication to the components when it's cold. Most of the wear happens when things are cold. Whatever it's an engine, whatever it's a transmission, differential, transfer case, whatever the case is, when fluids are cold. Most of the time, not always, but if that wear happens at a low, at a cold temperature, what happens when it's high? We already have a contamination in the fluid, and it's what it does, and it accelerates the wear. So your rear differential, front differential, maybe transfer cases using the gear oil will fail much faster, because when it's cold, it did not provide proper lubrication. Now it's when it's hot, you have those fine metal dust that accelerates the wear. Mobil 1, as you can see, it's already doesn't even meet. The Valvoline, it's up there. It still meets, but it's up there of being close to the maximum what is allowed for the gear oil. And if you look at the M-Soil, it provides 20% more cold temperature protection. So there you go, as you can see, you know that M-Soil wins. According to this report, there will be a link in my description where you can actually verify yourself and you read. And there is a big misunderstanding by some people. Some people think that independent labs are doing the work and testing for free. No, whoever requests, no one is going to work for free. No lab's going to work for free. Someone has to pay the bill. Someone has to pay for the equipment. To do the testing on oil, you need high-end and a very expensive equipment. So whatever the company is asking to do the testing pays for the test results. Is it biased? Of course not. It's like saying you go to the hospital and doctors has to do testing on you to test your blood to see why you're being ill, why you're being sick. And then saying, oh, doctors is being biased because they're testing my blood to find out what's wrong with me. That's silly. That's stupid thinking, you know. If you think that way, well, then you better educate yourself. So, and another thing, since I already found out, according to this report, that Mobil failed to meet the industry requirements, I decided, let's see if I can find the Brookfield viscosity for the Mobil. I started searching for the Mobil's website, I could not find Brookfield viscosity for the Mobil. It's not there. They would not give. I'm like, okay, what about Valvoline? Can I find something for the Valvoline? They don't even show that either. I'm all thinking, okay, so how valid is this test? I went to the AMSOL website and see if what's shown on the screen can be verified on AMSOL website. I was shocked. I'm like, no way. That's how transparent AMSOL is with their products. They show you everything. They don't hide information from consumers. If it meets, it meets. If it exceeds, it exceeds. Not like Mobil or Valor or other companies. They say, yay, meets and this and that, but they never show you the numbers. And I was able to actually this information, Brookfield Viscosity, it's on their website. And here is another thing. I start searching on Google, it's trying to see if there is any other test reports available. Another thing about a Mobil. Mobil and Valvoline and other brands. Here is, I want you guys to see. See this bottle? It's Lucas. Even Lucas doesn't meet specification requirements, actually. Believe it or not, I'll talk about it later. So this is the bottle size, this is the bottle shape that most of the gear oil comes. You can't squeeze everything out. You know, it's hard plastic, kind of soft, and you can't squeeze everything out. You have a lot of fluid being wasted. And if you go with a Mobil one, first, the product doesn't meet the requirement. Second, the bottle, you can't squeeze everything out. You're wasting a lot of fluid. You know, you gotta waste a lot of fluid to get your differential service. But when it comes to AMSOL, well, who would ever thought? A flexible, soft, but it's strong. You can squeeze everything out. You can actually roll it like a toothpaste and get every bit of oil. You don't need a pump, a hose, or anything. You can service your differential. You can service your transfer case without anything, any extra equipment. You just need the easy pack, AMSOL gear oil. First of all, it meets and exceeds. It's the best. I'm gonna show you guys the details, not just this report. Here is the other thing. I'm gonna show you guys. There will be a link in the description. I found this report online. A company, I didn't go to the details as to who requested the test and who tested. There were 14 samples tested in a Dana 60 drive axle. It's a full size axle that used by pickup trucks, Dana 60. And they tested in the Dana 60 in the lab under different conditions, under different loads, 14 different gear oils by different companies, Mobil, Pennzoil, you name it, they tested. And to my surprise, a lot of the companies that make gear oil, their products does not even meet specifications. Yes, they sell that stuff, and it does not meet specifications. And to my surprise, again, I'm surprised that this report, and you can read it on your own, this company that did that tested 14 different products of gear oil, different brands, this is what they wrote after the testing was done. And I'm gonna read it to you, and you can follow me on the screen. All the testing indicates AMSOL Severe Gear ranked highest among all gear loops tested. It was the only gear loop to score 4 or better in all performance category. The high ranking AMSOL Severe Gear clearly points to a well-balanced formulation capable of delivering effective, long-lasting lubrication protection to all different components. Most notably is the superior performance of AMSOL gear is critical in areas of extreme pressure protection and viscosity and exudation stability. Based on the performance testing, the slightly higher than average price AMSOL gear will be offset by cost savings achieved through reduced maintenance. And again, based on the performance testing, a slightly higher than average price of AMSOL Severe gear would be offset by cost savings achieved through reduced maintenance, longer lasting differential, and extended lubricant life. And by the way, slightly higher than average, Mobil actually cost more, according to Amazon. Their product actually cost more than AMSOL. As you can see, this company, this is what I was reading from their website or their test report, that their testing was verified and signed by the state, by the notary service. So there wasn't any, favorite there, you know, this report, it's interesting. I'll post a link. You can read it on your own. There's a lot of pages. There are lots of detailed information. How they tested, the equipment they were using it, for how long they were testing their gear oil, and everything is all, it's on that report. There will be a link where you can read, and there will be a link where you can make a purchase. If you believe the test results you're seeing on the screen, there will be a link where you can buy M-Soil products. And actually, with M-Soil in my personal cars, I seen the improvement in fuel economy, less drag, quieter differential, and it's overall, it's the best product you can buy. I want to thank you for subscribing, for watching this video. Drop me a comment in your comments, in the comment section. What is your experience with M-Soil gear oil? Thank you.